Hi everyone, I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. This is the Tenda RX12 Pro Wi-Fi 6 router. This is an AX3000 router. Now, you may be wondering why Tenda is releasing a new AX3000 router when they already have a model that is an AX3000, and I'm talking here about the RX9 Pro. So what I'll be doing in this video is that I'll be comparing the specifications of the RX12 Pro to the RX9 Pro, and also I'll be comparing the speed and the range of these two routers, so for you to be able to decide if you want to upgrade or no from the RX9 Pro to the RX12 Pro. And it will also help you if you're shopping for a new AX3000 router, what router to choose between the RX12 Pro and the RX9 Pro, because there's a slight price difference between the both routers. So let's start now by unboxing the router. Let me unbox it. So this is everything that comes in the box. You have the router, the power adapter, Ethernet cable, and some documentation. Let me show you the ports of this router. All the ports are on the back of the router. This one is for power. This pin here is to reset the router. This is a WPS button. This is the WAN port. It is a 1 Gbps WAN port. And these three here are LAN ports. And each one is 1 Gbps. The last one is for IPTV, so if you have an IPTV, you can connect it to it and it will take priority. And these are all the ports on this router. So you notice the lack of a USB port on the RX12 Pro router, and this is a shame. And this is a direct message for Tenda. Please put a USB port on your routers, at least the routers that are mid-range and more, because this will make your routers much more attractive than they are now. So that being said, the ports on the RX12 Pro are the same as the ports that are on the older model, that is the RX9 Pro, except for the coloring of the WAN port. On the older model, the RX9 Pro, it is yellow, whereas on the RX12 Pro, it is blue. And this is a nice touch because it is identifiable better than it is here. Also, on the RX12 Pro, the WPS button and the reset buttons are separated, whereas they are the same on the RX9 Pro. Let's talk about the specifications. This is a Wi-Fi 6 dual band AX3000 router. It has a 160 MHz channel, which is very good. It also has WPA3 security, OFDMA, and MU-MIMO, and these are like the high level specifications. And most importantly, this router now has a quad-core 1.7 GHz CPU, which is much better than the RX9 Pro that had 1.6 GHz dual-core CPU only. And also, as you notice, the RX12 Pro has 5 antennas, whereas the RX9 Pro has only 4 antennas. So, in theory, the RX12 Pro should be faster and should have better range than the RX9 Pro. But we're gonna verify this in a moment. Before we go to the speed test and to the range test, I'm going to talk about the features very quickly of the RX12 Pro, because they are exactly the same as the features in the RX9 Pro. So this router, on top of many other like basic settings and features, it has a VPN server, and it is only PPTP, unfortunately, and it has also a VPN client, which is PPTP and L2TP, so there is no OpenVPN here. It has a guest Wi-Fi, it has basic parental controls, and it has also basic QoS, and it has also multiple modes. On top of the router mode, it has also the access point mode, and it has also a mode called WISP, and this is mainly used in China. So now that we covered the specifications and the features, let's put this RX12 Pro to the test and compare its speed to the RX9 Pro, and the range also, we're gonna compare it to the RX9 Pro. So let's go and perform the speed test now. The first test I'm doing here is copying a large file that is 6.24 gigabytes from two PCs that are connected to the router on Wi-Fi 6. And you notice here that the RX12 Pro is much faster than the RX9 Pro. It is averaging 57 megabytes per second, whereas the RX9 Pro is averaging only 38 megabytes per second. Now I am testing the internet speed without any load on the internet. So I only have my PC connected to the internet, and I have a 120 megabits download speed and 20 megabits upload speed. And here both routers are giving their full potential and they're giving the full speed of the internet. In this test, I loaded my internet connection with many devices connected to the internet. On top of my PC, I have two TVs streaming 4K movies, I have two iPads streaming full HD videos, and I have my Amazon Echo playing music. And here you notice that both routers are coping very well with all this traffic, with a slight advantage to the RX12 Pro, but this is really a margin of error, and both routers here perform the same. I'm performing here the range test. I live in an apartment building, so I went out of my apartment into the hallway, and the RX9 Pro started cutting at the 40 yards mark, and just before it started cutting, it was giving a speed of 5.4 megabits per second. Whereas the RX12 Pro kept going strong until the 55 yards mark, and just before it cuts after the 55 yards mark, it was still giving a speed of 10 megabits per second. Before talking about the test results, I wanted to tell you that if you want to see how to set up this router, I have previously made a video on how to set up all Tenda routers. I'm going to leave a link in the description for this video if you want to check it out. Also, if you want to check out this router, I'm going to leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage, and this is at no cost to you, and this will help my channel greatly. Let's talk now about the test results. I'm going to start with the results where the RX12 Pro was better than the RX9 Pro. So the first area where the RX12 Pro was better is in the file copy operation, and it performed almost double the speed than the RX9 Pro, and this is because of its newer and faster quad-core processor. And also in the range test, it was much better than the RX9 Pro, and this is also thanks to its five antennas. Now, in the internet connection speed, whether the internet connection was loaded or not loaded, both routers performed the same. So my recommendation would be, if you want to copy files on your network and if you want better range, upgrade to the RX12 Pro from the RX9 Pro, because it is a worthy upgrade in these two cases. And if you're shopping for a new router, it's always better to get the latest version, especially that this router has a quad-core CPU. That was my review of the Tenda RX12 Pro AX3000 Wi-Fi 6 router. I hope that you liked my review and you found it useful, and I hope that my review will help you in your choice of purchasing a new Wi-Fi 6 router. If you liked my video, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give my video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss my future videos. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to put them in the comments section below, and I will be more than happy to answer all your questions and all your comments. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you on the next video.